Let us now study the experiment of comparison of two EMFs using a potentiometer. Here you can see this is the experimental setup in which for the sake of clarity, taken a potentiometer wire to be a straight wire of length L. And in this situation, you can see in the primary circuit, an EMF E1 is taken and along with the rheostat and an emitter, the primary circuit is completed. And on the other side in secondary circuit, we can see we have taken two EMFs, EU1 and EU2. These are two unknown EMFs which we are not aware about the values. And we are having a toggle over switch which is connected to the galvanometer and a jockey. Now initially say we keep the toggle switch on the position 1 so that the galvanometer is connected with the unknown EMF EU1. And say we balance the jockey on the wire and locate the null point. And say at this null point the balancing length we are finding as L1. So we can write the value of EU1 must be equals to lambda L1 if lambda is the potential gradient of this potentiometer wire. Now we toggle the switch to the position 2 where now the galvanometer is connected to the battery of EMF EU2. Now again say the jockey is balanced and the balancing length is L2. And we can write the value of EU2 is equals to lambda L2. Now from these two relations if we divide, this implies we are getting EU1 upon EU2 is equals to L1 upon L2. This is the way by which without even knowing the parameters of primary circuit, that is the potential gradient, we can directly calculate the ratio of these two EMFs which are unknown. So this is one of the best way to compare two unknown EMFs or even for calibration of known EMFs, this method can be used by which we can directly find out the numerical ratio of two EMFs.